battlefield for my Lord, for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord, for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. I am on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord, for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord, for my Lord. I promise him that I would serve him till I die. I am on the battlefield for my Lord. I was a wayward child. I didn't do the things I should. I took the master's hand and I joined the Christian band. You know that I promised him that I would serve him till I die. And I'm on a battlefield for my Lord. Church, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord, for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord, for my Lord. I promise him that I, yes, I did now. I promise him that I made a promise him that I would serve him. Promise him that I would serve him till I die. And I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Our scripture reading, Psalms 121. I will lift up my eyes into the hills, mm-hmm. from which cometh my help. Mm-hmm. My help comes from the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Which made heaven and earth.
Well,
he will not suffer thy foot to be moved. Mm-hmm. He that keepeth thee will not slumber.
Well,
behold, he that keepeth Israel, mm-hmm. shall neither slumber nor sleep.
Well,
the Lord is thy keeper. Mm-hmm. The Lord is thy shade,
yes,
upon thy right hand.
Well, mm-hmm.
the sun shall not smite thee by day, mm-hmm. none the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul.
Yes.
The Lord shall preserve thy going out, mm-hmm. and thy coming in from this time forth.
Yes, sir.
Even forevermore.
Amen.
That is the word of God, and I thank him for his word.
Amen.
A word of prayer. O God, mm-hmm. who's our creator,
yes,
of all mankind.
Well,
yes.
And oh Lord, you know, the world may turn to, mm-hmm. the politicians may turn to psychic, mm-hmm. may turn to the psychiatrist.
Well,
but oh Lord, you are my help.
Yes,
and you are my help. My help comes from you, mm-hmm. because you are the creator of heaven and earth.
Yes.
I thank you, oh God, for watching over us, mm-hmm. and never sleep. Amen. Matter of fact, you don't even blink an eye.
Well,
and I just want to say thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
You are shade at our right hand. Mm-hmm. Therefore, nothing can even come close to hurting me, because you're watching and protecting us, oh Lord. Mm-hmm. And Lord, I thank you that no evil. You protect us. Use a shield.
Yes.
You shield us from evil. Uh-huh. And I just want to say thank you, oh Lord.
Amen.
I thank you, oh God, that you watch our coming and our going.
Yes, sir.
And everything in between.
Well,
and I just said thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
I thank you, oh God, that you will not forsake us. You won't leave us. You won't turn your back on us. Mm-hmm. I thank you, oh God, that all our help comes from you, because I can do all things through you, because you give us the strength to
Amen.
Do. And I just want to say thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord, that we can look to you in these times, mm-hmm. because all our help comes from you. No matter what we're going through, we can just turn it over to you, Lord. Yeah. And I know everything will be all right. Mm-hmm. And then, Lord, I just thank you for everything that you have done for us. Please, oh Lord, mm-hmm. I ask you to continue to bless us, continue to watch over us, continue to keep us safe. Well, thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Bless our church family.
Yeah.
Bless the kids. Mm-hmm. Just bless our nation, oh Lord.
Amen.
Bless us, oh Lord.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
And I just thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That we can just look to you, mm-hmm. from which our help comes from.
Yeah.
Our help comes from nobody but you.
Amen.
And I just say much obliged.
Thank mm-hmm.
In yeah. Jesus' name.
Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Amen.
Good morning, one and all.
Good morning.
And on behalf of Reverend Jerry Walden, mm-hmm. and the Sand Hill and Tunnel Grove Baptist Churches,
well,
I would like to welcome you to our Sunday morning service. And I'm still beating that dead mule, the pandemic. It's still here.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of things being relieved, relaxed. And I don't know, I guess it's because a lot of people are getting vaccinated, but it's still here.
Mm-hmm.
And you still need to, wherever possible, social distance.
Yes.
Continue to wear your mask.
Yes, sir.
And continue to wash your hands.
Mm-hmm.
And my favorite, stay at home whenever possible.
Amen.
We just got to do it. It's the things has changed. This past year has been like no other that I've ever heard about.
Yes, sir.
You know, I've read about pandemics and things in history, but it didn't mean very much.
Yes.
But this one touched home.
Yes, sir.
So we be careful and continue to strive forward. Well, this morning, I have a little small story for you, a little short one.
Mm-hmm.
There were these two men, they got marooned.
Mm-hmm.
On an island.
Well,
and one of them was just pacing. He was scared to death. You know, I'm going to die. We don't have any food to eat. We can't drink this salt water. He was just pacing. And he happened to notice that his friend was over there leaning up against a tree with a leg crossed with him.
Mm. All right.
And he stopped and said, man, what's wrong? What's the matter? You don't think we're going to die? No, I'm not worried about that. And he said, wait, come on over here and have a seat. I'm going to let you know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
He got over there. He jumped up, stopped pacing. He said, wait a minute, let me talk to you. He said, look here. I make $100,000 a week.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And I tithe faithfully every week to my church. I'm not worried, because my pastor going to find me. Welcome.
Amen.
It makes me love all my enemies.
me do right when I would do wrong.
Services today. It is always good that you are tuned in to us and that you are sharing with us. And as we come today, we just come reminding us that the Lord is still in the blessing business.
Amen.
He's still in the blessing business. This morning, I want to call your attention to New Testament teaching in the book of Matthew chapter 18. And verses 11 through 14. Matthew chapter 18 and verses 11 through 14. Mm-hmm. At this time, let us pray. Eternal Father, we come in the most humble manner that we know how. Mm-hmm. Come thanking thee for the blessings that you have already bestowed upon us. Sir, it has gotten to be preaching time. Mm-hmm. We ask that you give us a word to give to your children. And give us receiving hearts. Because somebody need to hear a word today. Somebody's down and out. Somebody doesn't see their way. But Father, if you just bless us, we shall be all right. Just come and take over. And whatever you do, it's all right, sir. Bless us now with those blessings that we stand in need of. This is our cry. Amen. Again, New Testament teaching. In the book of Matthew, Matthew chapter 18, verses 11 through 14. Listen at what these words said to us. And this is Jesus speaking to them, to us today. Matthew 18, starting with verse number 11. For the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. How think ye, if a man have 100 sheep, and one of them be gone astray, do he not leave the 99 and goeth into the mountains and seek that which is gone astray? And if so be that he find it, verily I say unto you, he rejoice more of that sheep than of the 99 which were not astray. Even so, it is not the will of your Father that which is in heaven, that one of these little ones should perish. The word of God for the children of God.
Amen.
A little while this morning, I want to talk to you from the subject, God cares about you.
All right.
God cares about you. Mm-hmm. Now, we may begin this message, brothers and sisters, by saying to you, this is one of the most famous parables by Jesus in the Bible.
Amen.
This is known as the parable of the lost sheep, or the parable of the seeking shepherd. This parable holds a great message for both the believer and the non-believer.
All right.
In this parable, Jesus uses the word, these little ones. This phrase refers to the genuine Christian believers. Mm-hmm. And in the time that we are living, some of us wonder, are all Christians real and for true?
Well,
and I'm here to remind you, some are, y'all. Some are. Jesus also uses the word perish, which refers to the lost sheep. Mm-hmm. On this occasion, Jesus was talking to his disciples, our believer. Note some of the things Jesus is sharing here. He shares with us, some believers are weak.
Amen.
He shares with us, some believers do not grow. Mm-hmm. He shares with us in this parable that some believers wander away.
Amen.
Some believers are stubborn. Now, I know that that's how to hit some of y'all. And we don't have folk like that in the church. Amen,
preacher.
Some believers become self-centered.
Uh-huh.
We find all of this within the church and around about the church.
Amen.
But in all of this, the Lord still cares about every one of us.
Amen.
For it is John 3:16 that said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Mm-hmm. Now let us move into this lesson. As we begin to move into this lesson and look at verse number 11, this verse tells us Jesus came to save the lost.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus came to save the lost. This is the mission statement for Jesus coming to earth.
Amen.
Jesus came to save the lost. Jesus came to save sinners. He came to save sinners just like you and me.
All right.
For it is Matthew 18:11 where Jesus said, for the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost.
Yeah.
What does that mean? That means that Jesus came down from heaven willingly.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Nobody forced him to come. He came on his own and he came willingly. Not only did he come willingly, but when Jesus came down, he came down deliberately. Mm-hmm. He had made plans to come.
Yes.
Not only that, but just think about it. He left all of the conference together to come down to earth so that somebody like me and you could be saved. Mm-hmm. Jesus was not forced to come.
Nope.
Nobody put a gun to his head and said, you got to go, you must go. That was a choice that Jesus made himself. Jesus left of his own will to come to earth to save sinners like you and me.
All right.
Jesus was able to see that mankind had gone astray. Jesus was able to see that mankind needed help.
Yeah.
It needed help thousands of years ago. Guess what? It still needs help right now.
All right.
Jesus did something about it. He saw the need, and he did something about it. Y'all, can I tell you something about the church today? Sometimes we see a need, but we don't do nothing about it.
Amen.
Jesus saw a need, and he did something about it. The old church used to say, Jesus came down through 42 generations to save a sinner like you and me. Again, he wasn't forced. It was a decision that he made on his own to come down and save those that want to be saved. Well, John 3:16, one of our favorite verses. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. All this is telling us that God cares about you. Then when I look at verse number 12, I see something there. I see in verse number 12, Jesus seeks the lost.
Well,
Jesus seeks the lost. This is awesome, y'all. This is good news, y'all. Jesus seeks every single sheep that is lost. Not some of them, but every single sheep that is lost. He seeks every sheep that needs a helping hand.
Well,
brothers and sisters, this is great news. This is good news to know that we have a Savior like Jesus Christ. While seeking the lost, he still takes care of those that are yet at home with him. He got the ability to seek those that are lost, and then those that are still with him, he still takes care of them.
All right.
Now, doesn't that make you feel good?
Oh, yeah.
Jesus is concerned about everyone. He's concerned about those that are doing the best that they can. He's concerned about those that have gone astray. And y'all, don't start pointing fingers this morning at nobody.
Because
all of us have gone astray
at
some point or another. Jesus is concerned about those that are lost in the wilderness. Please keep in mind, it is the shepherd that seeks after the lost sheep. Let me tell you about the shepherd. Can I just tell you a couple of things about this shepherd? One of the things I want to tell you about our shepherd, he's patient. Y'all missed that. I said, he's patient.
All right, preacher.
Me and you, sometimes we get in a hurry. We got to do this. This minute, I should have done this yesterday, but I'm getting to it now. Jesus is patient, y'all.
Yes, he is.
Not only is he patient, but he is enduring. He go through some things to get you and I to come over on his side. And thirdly, Jesus never give up on us, y'all.
Amen.
See, we'll give up on one another, y'all. We'll give up on ourselves sometimes. But Jesus never gives up on us. He depends on his voice to bring the lost back to the fold, y'all. And Jesus is working every day in our lives to get those of us that don't know the Lord to come over on his side. And I just need to stop long enough to tell you, while the blood is yet running warm in your veins, you need to make up your mind that I'm going to come over on the Lord's side.
Yes.
You need to make up your mind, I'm going to come over and I'm going to serve the Lord. I'm going to do the best that I can. You might not do like some others, but just do the best that you can. That's all the Lord requires of you. Luke 19:10 said, for the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. All I'm telling you this morning is God cares about you. Well, Rev, how you know God cared? When I looked at verse 13, I saw something there. When Jesus seeks the lost, Jesus may or may not find the lost sheep, y'all.
Amen.
That's all we got to do.
All right,
I said, he seeks, but he may or may not find the lost sheep. And let me just give you the end of the story. Every sheep that is lost does not desire to be found.
All right, preacher.
That's right.
Now that's hard there, y'all. In one sense, this statement is scary. Finding the lost sheep is not a sure thing. Finding the lost sheep depends on many things. One of the things that it depends on, how far astray has the lost sheep wandered?
Come on.
And you know, we used to have a saying in the church. Said, don't go too far. Don't stay too long. And don't get back too late.
All right, preacher.
I'm here to tell you, it's possible that you might not get back on time.
All right.
So while the blood is yet running warm in your veins, you need to come over on the Lord's side.
Yeah.
Jesus may or may not find the lost sheep. A second thing that I want to tell you about. When Jesus calls out to the lost sheep, all lost sheep do not respond, y'all.
That's right, man. All right. Amen. All right, preacher.
I know right about it.
Yes, sir.
All lost sheep do not respond.
Mm-hmm.
Many ones, many have been lost. Mm-hmm. They heard the voice of Jesus.
Yes, sir.
But they did not respond.
All right.
Mm-hmm. If they respond, they responded in a negative way. They turned their back on the Lord, y'all. So I'm here to tell you, yes, the Lord is seeking the lost sheep. And when he knocks on your door, don't put it out for tomorrow. Because remember, tomorrow is not promised.
Amen.
Amen.
Some have gone and fallen in some deep holes.
Yes,
and for some kind of reason, they are not able to hear the shepherd voice.
Well.
So they are not able to respond to the calling of the Lord. And many times, when those fall in a deep hole, they just completely give it up. You've seen some of these. Some folk that were brought up in the church. Their mama and their daddy, their grandmama and their granddad, they were lying in the church. They believed in the church. But the children wandered away.
Yes,
and they tried all they could to get them to come back to the church. But they turned a deaf ear to the word of God and to their mamas and daddy.
Yes,
y'all.
Amen.
Y'all, that happened in the past.
Mm-hmm.
Guess what? They still doing that now.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Some are being told about the Lord,
mm-hmm.
but they don't want to hear that. They want to hear everything but that, y'all.
Amen.
For it is Proverbs 29:1 that says, he that being often reproved hardens his neck shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. So I'm here to tell you, you can't go too far.
Mm-hmm.
You can't stay too long.
Amen.
And you can't get back too late, y'all.
So, all right,
don't let it be said about you, y'all. Don't let it be said about you.
Amen.
God cares about you.
Mm.
And in verse number 13, it tells us Jesus forgives and rejoices and recovers the ones that are lost that won't be recovered.
Well,
yes, sir. Amen.
This is good news. It does not give Jesus pleasure to lose a son or daughter. He doesn't take any pleasure in that, y'all.
Amen.
It hurts into his heart. Mm-hmm. He does not have a party when one go off and will not come back. He is hurting, y'all. But when one that was lost come back to the fold,
yes, sir.
Jesus rejoices.
Yes, sir.
Those of us that know the Lord, we rejoice too.
Amen.
It's a good thing. To know that somebody has gone out and they have changed their mind and come back home to the Lord, it ought to give us joy, y'all.
Amen.
For a fellow brother, our fellow sister, to come back to the Lord.
Y'all. Amen.
Jesus forgives and rejoices over the recovered sinner. For it is Luke 15:6-7 that says, and when he cometh home, he called together his friends and neighbors, saying unto them, rejoice with me, For I have found my sheep with my law.
Yes.
Say unto you that likewise joy shall be in heaven more than over 99 just persons which needed no repentance.
Amen. All right.
All I'm telling you is that God cares about you.
Well,
and lastly, in verse number 14, it tells us that God does not want one to perish. It is not God's desire that anybody be lost.
Well,
he wants everybody to be saved.
Yeah,
he wants everybody to come on home and come over on the Lord's side. God wants all of us to be blessed.
Yes.
But in the end, it's left up to you and me.
Amen.
Nobody can force you to come over on the Lord's side. Nobody can make you come over on the Lord's side. But I read and I studied in the Word that Jesus always stands with outstretched hand,
yes, sir,
for those that have gone astray to come on home.
Oh, yes.
So I'm saying to anybody that they know they're not where they need to be.
Yes.
This is a good time to come on home.
Yes, sir.
Because God cares about you. And he got those outstretched arms. But the thing is, you got to come while you got a chance, y'all.
Yes, sir.
Because time is coming to an end.
Amen.
Look at the things that are happening around us.
All right, preacher.
The Lord is simply warning us.
Yes, sir.
Telling us to get out of our business fix and get things in order so that we can come back home and hands it well done.
Well done.
By good and faithful.
All right.
So I'm here to tell you, we need to get it together, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
And all it takes is just saying a prayer.
Yes, sir.
And don't be stubborn when you say prayer, your prayers, y'all. See, some of us like to be stubborn. We like for folk to look up to us and say, look how big and strong he is. What good is big and strong,
amen,
and dying and going to hell, y'all?
All right, preacher.
You need to humble yourself.
Yes, sir.
And come on back to the Lord and admit that you made some mistakes in life.
Yes,
admit,
sir,
that you've done some wrong things.
Yes, sir.
But ask the Lord to forgive you.
Yes, man.
And you come on back and humble yourself. I'm here to tell you, there's a blessing in that, y'all. So while the blood is yet running warm, you need to come on back home so that the Lord can take care of you. And I'm here to tell you, ain't nobody can do you like the Lord.
Nobody.
He can give you joy when there isn't any joy.
Yes, sir.
He can be a friend when there isn't a friend, y'all.
Yes, sir.
But you got to accept it for whole years, y'all.
Uh-huh.
And while he's reaching out his hand to his children, let us catch a hold to that hand and let us come on back to the Lord's side. For the cause, the Lord is still in the blessed business.
Yes,
I wonder, do I have anybody that been out there for a while, began to think that I need to come on home?
Thank you.
While the sun is yet shining in my life, because this scripture teaches me you can wait too late. So I'm telling all of you, don't wait too late.
All right.
Come on back while you got a chance.
Yes, sir.
And hear the Lord say, well done, thy good and faithful servant.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you. At this time, we're going to extend an invitation. There might be somebody that want to come over on the Lord's side. This is a good time to come. And you wish to come and become a part of the church. This church, any church. Again, we encourage you, get in touch with me. And we will guide you and direct you in the way that you wish to go. You don't have to be a member of Temple Road. You can be a member of anybody in the church. And I'll help you to get in contact with whoever you need to. But you need to be in the Lord's church, y'all.
Amen.
And again, I'm telling you, time is winding for now. And if there be one that desires to become a member of the church, get in touch with me, and we will help you to get to where you need to be.
Amen.
At this time, let us pray. Eternal Father, we ask now that you just bless us and that you just be with us and take care of us.
Mm-hmm.
And those sheep that are lost, we ask that you direct them back to the fold.
Amen.
And that they come back to you.
Mm-hmm.
Because we realize that time is winding down, mm-hmm, in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And that we don't have as long as we used to have. Just bless, Father. And we stand with open arms. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit and the love of Jesus Christ go and abide with you wherever you go. This is our prayer. Amen.
Amen.